A lie can travel halfway around the world, while the truth is still putting its pants on. This may have been something that you've heard before, once or twice in your lifetime, maybe more. And it's a fairly wise statement in our current climate, in culture, pop culture, entertainment, news, any form of information. The lies are stacking up, and they're stacking up quite high, at least right now. While I stay very far away from politics on my channel, I found a tweet set that actually illustrates my point, and it does so very completely. It also sheds light on how indoctrination leads to inaccurate information, maybe even on purpose. Let's go.
Ladies and gentlemen, Is and Foes, welcome to the Culture Casino!
Social media, in some form or another, is in your life. It's a part of your life. Case in point, if you're watching this video right now, you're engaged in a social media platform. Now, the original idea around these platforms was simple. It was elegant. Gave people access to their friends, their relatives, through the magic of the internet. Gave them access to some information that they may not otherwise have easily found. The platforms rose and fell like a swell in the ocean, of course. Many of them still exist in long-forgotten dusty closets of the internet, or hidden corners, or whatever you'd like to say. But I'll give you an example. Go see if you still have your MySpace available. Believe it or not, it's still out there. Things have seemed to evolve out of specific need when it comes to these platforms. Messaging gets more advanced, so Twitter rises out of that need. Messaging platforms were not quite as elegant. They had limitations. Twitter replaced that, even though it is lacking specific interfaces and features. Now, Twitter, the little blue bird, the application that started as a communication tool that was favored by thoughtful and insightful people that were abandoning ICQ and AIM, it became the instant message information distribution platform of choice, of course. To this end, a new batch of people developed followings. They became influencers. They became wealthy through sponsorships and endorsements and endorsement deals. Twitter offered people the ability to be verified and offered different colored check marks to indicate their verified status of what type and kind. Then came the political divide in this country and around the world, and a shift in power. Platforms changed how they treated people and how they treated information. They had to do this because in their mind, they would lose power if they did not. Their power had become threatened. By now, all of this is old news to many, if not most or all of you. And you've seen it or experienced it or seen other people experience it. And yet, there's way more to this story. Today, we have an example of how a lie is so much more powerful and often goes completely unchecked if you are in favor with a given platform. Enter the mind of Dr. Reza Aslan. What's he a doctor of, you ask? Sociology. He's been an apostate of more than one faith. He's collected multiple degrees from all around the United States and has been a reporter of sorts, correspondent, contributor for the news organization CNN. Interviews with many famous uber progressives have given him too much influence, in my opinion, and all of this has earned him a checkmark that he sports over on Twitter. Now, it came as no surprise to me when he tweeted out at about 10:09 a.m. on February 19th a screenshot. It was a tweet of a lie that was being attributed to Ted Cruz. Now, his quote associated with a screenshot of the tweet was, "This is a real tweet," as you can see here. Saying that this is a real tweet, it's garnered him over 180,000 likes at the time that I took this screenshot. Now, it also has obviously over 31,000 retweets and over 4,000 replies. This thing moved. And it moved pretty quickly. It was all, you know, as part of a massive movement to, you know, cast Ted Cruz in a negative light, of course. Now, the problem for a person like Mr. Aslan is that his screenshot was a complete fabrication. And the second problem was the fact that he didn't actually retract it once he knew that this was true, that it was a lie. In fact, his lie sat on social media and may still even be there to this very moment. I wouldn't know when you're watching this video. Instead of deleting the fabrication, he just, quote, retweeted, saying, "Oh, I guess it's not." Of course, as you can see, that tweet, that retweet of his original tweet, has only garnered 275 replies, 106 retweets, which one of those is mine, and 524 likes. You see the difference? Demonstrating the fact, of course, what the difference is the fact that the lie continues to be spread. And it's pretty disgusting. So the questions are, and there are many, where is the fact-checking and the cancellation of the original tweet? Where is Twitter on this? Shouldn't they be right there calling this out? These are good questions. Of course, there's not going to be an answer. No statement at the bottom of the original tweet that's stating that it's a falsehood, like you find so many other tweets, or even on videos like this, across multiple different kinds of platforms. No, it's just the lie that's continuing to be spread by a CNN contributor that, I would like to say this is a first, but it's not. The person letting this misinformation spread is the same person who decided that it was okay or a good idea to eat human brains. Yep, as part of a story for CNN's Believers show, I guess, this person engaged in cannibalism. Now, the video is still available. You can find it pretty much on most of the video media distribution platforms. And this episode, of course, came under quite a bit of fire by those that actually practice Hinduism. And this particular segment is highlighting a very extreme sect of that practices the religion. In fact, Tulsi Gabbard herself had a very strong reaction to the portrayal of her religion, Hinduism. Now, the problem right now, and I'm sure that we all agree to some extent, is that once people started conflating the truth with their truth, and facts with their feelings, we started separating more and more from reality. Science, mathematics, history are all being destroyed right now and being remade, essentially, to change and eliminate any progress that we've made in any of these fields. And, of course, certain people don't see it that way. Huge efforts have been made to reinvent words and their meanings and to strip away any common understanding that we may have had as individuals, society, a nation, and a world. There are dark undertones that seem to be rising in a society that's this divided, and that can only be rectified by exposing the lies and revealing the truths. It can be done. It takes a lot of work. Twitter, of course, is at odds with that right now, as are many of the other social platforms, because drawing attention to the fact that the people that seem to be, I don't know, influencing some of the things in the world are out and out hypocrites, liars, etc. Power-hungry humans that I guess they want to cater to. And why does this supposedly learned man, this Dr. Aslan, Dr. Aslan, leave up the misinformation that is still, like, possibly still available as you watch this video? The conclusion is a simple one. His lack of genuine effort to fix this is actually the real meaning of aberrant. He doesn't mind the lie being spread. In fact, it suits his purpose, his cause. It suits the needs of his particular ideology, let's say it that way. And to quote, of course, one very notable creator of G&G, this makes him a trash person. Anyway, I don't often get political on the channel, and I don't really believe this was all that political. It's just calling out the hypocrisy that we see on day-to-day social media and any other form of platform, even this one. So anyway, if you enjoyed the video, please leave a comment below. If you have any comments, you have questions, if this is the kind of thing you want to see, which again, this is a lot different, you may want to venture over to the channel that I'm creating called Culture Casino News. Hopefully, there'll be some content up there real soon, depending upon when you watch this video, it may already be up there. But do check that out. Be sure to support other independent creators here on the platform, because they don't have an industry supporting them. They really don't even have the platform that they're on supporting them. The platform that they're on would wish that they would go away because they don't like the hypocrisy being pointed out. Anyway, please support as many of these wonderful creators as you possibly can. And on that note, of course, thank you very much for being here. I truly appreciate it. Be sure to take care of yourself. Take care of others. Wash your hands, of course, because it's good hygiene. Really is, guys. You should do that. And until next time, bye. Hey there. One last quick note before I let you go. And before we make it to the end of this video, I, Culture Casino, have a brand new Teespring store. That's right. You can now go to Teespring, look up Culture Casino, or use the link in the video below, and pick out some handsome and beautiful Culture Casino merchandise with many different designs and styles and colors, many different items. I was actually surprised at all of the things that you could create, and I have some more designs and items on the way here shortly. But, you know, if you want to support the channel in that way, there is some merch. Otherwise, here comes the ending.
Thanks for visiting today. Be sure you're subscribed and hit that for alerts.
Yay!
Of course, like and share all of the videos that you can, as it helps with the algorithm. Have a great day.